the last part in the present tenses, that is present perfect continuous tense. You might have understood very well what is meant by present perfect tense and what is meant by present continuous tenses. If you combine these two, you will get this a very very important present perfect continuous tense. In this video, we are going to study what are the different structures, what are the different uses, application side of this present perfect continuous tense. Present perfect continuous tense. Let us move. Next, you see, this is actually we have been talking about, discussing about. We have been watching this on different videos. So, what are the primary types of tenses? There is, you know, present tense, past tense, and future tense. These three tenses, you know, what are the subcategories? Thus, also, you know, let us revise once. So, present tense, past tense, future tense. These are three categories, main categories. On the other side, we have simple tense, continuous tense, perfect tense, perfect continuous tense. If we combine these three into four, we get totally 12 kinds of categories, 12 categories of tenses. So out of this, we have covered, you know that we have covered this one, simple present tense we covered in the first video, and we have covered this one also, this present continuous tense also, we know. Next one, present perfect tense also we know, and finally now we are going to study this one, present perfect continuous tense. Present perfect continuous tense, 8 more blocks are remaining. Those things will be completed in the subsequent videos. Let us see here, present perfect continuous tense. So this is continuous process, a continuous process from the past to the present, that is going to be continued in future also. In that kind of situations we use present perfect continuous tense. Here you see, I have combined these two, present perfect plus present continuous, gives rise to present perfect continuous tense. This present perfect continuous is also called as present perfect progressive tense. Present perfect progressive, continuous other meaning is progressive, continuous other meaning is progressive, don't be confused. So here present perfect tense, we use this have, we use have in present perfect tense, have plus a past participle. Whereas in continuous tense, we use one helping verb, be form of the helping verb plus a ing form, main verb plus ing, these two things. We combine these two things in a present perfect continuous tense. So it is very easy if you know present perfect tense, if you know present continuous tense, if you combine these two things, and you will get present perfect continuous tense. You will see these things in a different structures, in a adjective sentence, negative sentence, and interrogative sentences, and you will get a very excellent knowledge if you watch this video till the end. Till the end, let us move. Here I have given you the definition of present perfect continuous tense. The tense which shows that some action was started in the past, some action started in the past or was started in the past and is continuing at the present time, and is continuing at the present time, we call it as a, so past to present, past to present, this is the main theme of this tense, that is a present perfect continuous tense, present perfect continuous tense. So here, importance of the present perfect tense is given. First one is a time duration, time duration. Second one is a time amount. These two things we are going to get through present perfect continuous tense. So time duration, what is the time, for how long some action happened, and next one, what is the amount of time, or the period of time, that is a point of time, time duration, time amount, all these things we are going to know. Let us see what are the different prepositions and what are the different structures, what are the different ways of using this present perfect continuous tense. The structure formation involves two important things. One is a auxiliary verb or a helping verb. Auxiliary verb or a helping verb. Second one, main verb. Second one, main verb. Here, two auxiliary verbs are used. In the case of present perfect tense, only one auxiliary verb we have used. In the case of present continuous tense and present perfect tense, only one auxiliary verb or helping verb we used. Whereas in the case of present perfect continuous, to have, that is has or have we use. Second one, we add a been also. Have been or has been. So then we get the present perfect continuous tense. So two important things. Two helping verbs, one main verb. Totally here we are using three verbs. Two helping verbs, that is have or has, plus been, plus main verb. So we get a present perfect continuous tense. Here you see subject plus have plus been plus present participle, that is a base verb, plus ing, we get a present perfect tense. So subject plus have plus been plus main verb, that main verb has a base verb plus ing forms. Then here I have given one example, hi, that is a subject, have been, read plus ing, base verb read plus ing form. So this tense, I have been reading. So like this we form. So that much we don't think while writing or talking. With practice we automatically get this one. Our mind will automatically generate this on our tongue or in our hands. So don't worry, practice makes us perfect. So next one, conversions. So here for the sake of your understanding, to avoid confusion, I have given conversion, that is from simple present tense to present continuous tense, from present continuous tense to present perfect, then present perfect to present perfect continuous tense. So here in the first sense, we make ties. Here no helping verb we have used. We used directly the main verb. The second thing, one helping verb we used and one main verb with the ing forms. We are making toys. So that is present continuous tense. In the case of present perfect tense, one helping verb have or has we used and one main verb made we used. Whereas in the case of, I have already told you, in the case of present perfect continuous tense, three verbs we use, two helping verbs, that is one is have, second one is been, third one making, like this. So in the first case, no helping verb. In present continuous and present perfect tense, one helping verb, one main verb. In the case of present perfect continuous tense, two helping verbs and one main verb plus ing forms we use. So we make toys, we are making toys, we have made toys, we have been making toys, we have been making toys. So this is very very important to avoid confusion. So very very easy, we can learn it very. I think you have been perfect with the three tenses, and this is the fourth one. This will add a feather into your cap. Auxiliary verb or helping verb varies with the person. Just like in the case of simple present tense, in third person singular, we added a s to the main verb. In the same way, in the present continuous tense, we use s, that is a is form in the present in the for third person singular. In the case of present perfect tense, we added a s to have to get a has. This you know, main verb plus s, so then helping verb is, then helping verb has. In the same thing we will follow with respect to present perfect continuous tense. We will see here assertive sentences or positive sentence or statements. We are going to study first of all this one, assertive sentence, or we call, there are the three different names for this, assertive or positive statements. We will study these things first of all. So here one table is given, all persons except third person singular, except third person singular. So here I have given first person singular, FPS means first person singular, FPP means first person plural, SS means second person singular or plural. Next one, third person plural, third person plural. For all kinds of persons except the third person singular, we don't use a s forms. So here you can see for all the persons we have used have been. Next, see, I have been, we have been, you have been, they have been, ants have been, ants have been. Next one, we have added main verb. Main verbs, here you can see main verbs, greeting, attending, watering, producing, searching. These are the main verbs plus ing forms. Then we have added the object or predicates like this. First one, you see, I have been greeting messages, I have been getting messages, we have been attending online classes. Second person singular, you have been watering garden plants. Third person plural, they have been producing fruits. Third person plural, ants have been searching for grains. Like this we use. So this point we have to keep in mind. In a simple present tense, we added s to the main verb. In present continuous tense, in the helping verb is, we got a s. Whereas in the case of present perfect tense, we added s to have to get has. Here you see have been, same have been for all persons except third person singular. Next we see third person singular. See, you can see here it is very, for all things we have has. This is important. Has been, has been, has been, has been. Third person singular. He is also third person singular. She is also third person singular. It is also third person singular. The boy is also third person singular. So verbs are there. Writing is one main verb. Stitching is another main verb. Flying is another main verb. Running another main verb. So first one, you see, he has been writing exams. She has been stitching clothes. It has been flying. The boy has been running. So these are the structures. So third person singular has, for remaining persons have. So these are, this is the chief difference while writing or talking or speaking. So you have to keep this point in your mind. Next we see how to convert present perfect tense from assertive to negative sentences, from positive to negative sentences. So we keep this not, we keep this not in between have and been. In between have and been, we insert a not to get negative sentences. We see, I have been bringing, I have been bringing, you see. So this is aim is assertive. In negative sentences, we simply put not in between. I have not been bringing. So that's all. So in the case of present perfect tense, we put a not in between have and main verb. Whereas in the case of present perfect continuous tense, we put a not between two helping verbs, that is have and been. Two helping verbs, no. In between we keep a not. The same way, one more example, you see, you have been obeying, you have not been obeying. So here we have inserted not between two helping verbs, that is between have and been, we insert a not. In another example, you can see, she has been riding. So we insert not in between has and been. In between has and been, we get a negative sentences. Very, very easy. English is very easy. If you learn tenses, I think your 25% English would be perfect. Remaining 25% depends on passive voice, and remaining 50% depends on other aspects of grammar. Let us go to interrogative sentences, how to make them. We have learned how to make assertive to interrogative sentence with respect to simple present tense, present continuous tense, and present perfect tense. The same rule here also applies, but here two helping verbs are there. That why a little bit carefulness we have to maintain. So here assertive to interrogative sentence. So exchange of same subject and a helping verb have takes place. Exchange will take place. Subject in the place of subject, have will come. In the place of have, subject will go. So this is going to happen here. So here you see one example. We have been drawing. Have we been drawing? So here you can see this we have becomes have we. We have becomes have. Only difference is in the first sentence, W is capital, because first letter should be capital. Here H will be capital letter. So that is a difference. That is a difference. Remaining thing is it. We have will become have we. So here actually our caliber depends. So at the end, anyhow, we are using a interrogative mark or question mark. These two things important: exchange of a helping verb and subject, and second one is using a interrogative mark or question mark. One more example we are going to see. They have been praising. How they have been praising? See this one. This difference, they have becomes how they. So this is the present. Have goes to the place of they goes to the place of have. So this interchange will happen. That's enough. We will get a interrogative form. So then question mark or interrogative mark. So one more example we are going to see. He has been jumping. Has he been jumping? That's also. Has goes to the place of he. He goes to the place of has goes to the place of he. So this will happen. In the first case, has goes to the place of he. Sorry, in the second place, same thing. So he has becomes has he. He has been jumping. Has he been jumping? Here, interrogative mark should come. So these two things important: inter exchange of subject and helping verb, and question mark. These two things we can get a interrogative sentence, just like in the case of simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense. For present perfect continuous tense also it is very very easy. So next we are going to see what are the different uses of or application aspects of present perfect continuous tense. First usage application aspects of present perfect continuous tense, that is unfinished actions we use. So what is it, unfinished actions? So in the case of since, some point of time in the past to till now, some point. Since indicates a point, since for point. So two aspects, started in the past, continuing till now. For these things we use a present perfect continuous tense. So example, Anand has been distributing pamphlets since morning. Morning is a point. That's why we use since morning. Udayamu nundi. So here we have used has been distributing. This is a present perfect continuous tense. Anand has been distributing pamphlets since morning. For in this case we use a present perfect continuous tense. So very very important point. Next one, I have been collecting money since last month. Last month is the point here, so that's why we have used since. So have been collecting is a present perfect continuous tense. I have been collecting money since last month. That means still I am collecting money. So the process has not ended. Started in the past and is being continued even till now, and may continue in future also. For this kind of things we use a present perfect continuous tense. So next one, it has been flowering since 2018. That means we planted a plant in 2018 and it has been a flowering. So since we have used it, it has been flowering since 2018. So that is the meaning. So it has been flowering and it will continue to flower. It will continue to flower. So next use, for indicates a period of time. It is, don't forget, since a point of time, for a period of time. For always denote period of time, since a point of time, to show certain period of a time. Examples, he has been counting for an hour. He has been counting for an hour. An hour is a period of time. So that's why we have used for. That's why you have for an hour. And he will continue in future also. So he has been counting for an hour. So here your present perfect continuous tense has been counting. Next example, you have been growing it for 6 months. So here 6 months is the period of time. 6 months is the period of time. For indicates that period. So what is the present perfect continuous tense have been growing indicates present perfect continuous tense for this preposition we use for a period of time. What is the period of time here? 6 months. In this case we use a present perfect continuous tense. So one more example, we have been suffering for a decade. What is the period of time here? A decade. Prepositions we use for. So what is the present perfect continuous tense? Have been suffering present perfect continuous tense for preposition a decade, period of time. So here we have used a present perfect continuous tense. So next we use recently, especially when we use the adverb recently, we use a present perfect continuous tense. Mamata has been selling flowers recently. Means she has started selling flowers recently. Has been selling, present perfect continuous tense. And here we have used a recently adverb. In this case also, present perfect continuous tense. So next one, lately. So for this adverb also we use, my uncle has been recovering. This is present perfect continuous tense. So two helping verbs and one main verb, lately. So in this sense also we use. Recently we use for finished actions. With a result, but without a time word. Without using a time word also, for a recently finished actions we use. For example, I am so tired. So, I am so tired. So, present tiredness is because of I have been working. For a long period of time, I have been working. That's why I am so tired. Here, no period of time, no point of time. In this case also, we can use. So, in the same way, we have been running, so we are really exhausted. Why? Because we have been running. In here also no period of time, no point of time, no since, no far. This sense also we can use. It has been raining, so the road is wet. Why the road is wet? This is a question. Why the road is wet? Because it has been raining. It has been raining for 1 hour, for 2 hours, or for the entire day, or for 3 days. That is a different thing. Without indicating point of time or period of time, we can use a present perfect continuous tense in this sense. In this sense also we can use. The last part of this video is a few errors and corrections. Just like we have learned these things in simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, you please revise those videos and that notes again and again, so that our present foundation will become very strong. Tenses, voices, the basic foundation for our English grammar. So these things will make us build castles over that strong foundation. So errors and corrections. First thing is, don't use a non-continuous verbs. This we learnt in a present continuous tense. Non-continuous tenses, that it itself indicates we should not use in continuous forms. Non-continuous and continuous are opposite things, so we don't use. What are the non-continuous verbs? We have learnt so many: know, have, see, smell, hate, hear, understand, want, like this. Many, I mentioned a number of non-continuous verbs in present continuous tense. You once again refer them. So far in this sense, we don't use a. We see some example. wrong one. I have been hearing this we have learned. I am hearing is also wrong. I have been hearing is also wrong. So here I have heard is correct. There heard was correct. So this is very important. I have been hearing is wrong. I have heard is correct. Next one. She has been owning this property for 5 years. Has been owning wrong. Non-continuous, in continuous sense is wrong. Has owned is correct. She has owned this property for 5 years. This is a revision for a present continuous tense also. In present continuous tense also, we don't use a non-continuous verbs in a continuous form. Same thing here. One more example. Laya has been being late for school. Has been being. So, been. One, be form. Two be forms we cannot use. Be plus be. Be plus be. Awkward forms we don't use. Superfluous forms. So, what is the correct one? Has been. That's all. Has been late for school. Laya has been being late for school wrong. Laya has been late for school is correct. So we have learned present perfect continuous tense. So our present tense, four types, subtypes: simple present, present continuous, present perfect continuous. We have been successfully finished. On that ground, we can go for past tenses and then future tenses also. After watching this video, write down, first you see the recapitulation, then you write down the notes, then you write your own sentences regarding your yesterday or today's activities. Okay, Mark.